from the news leader. Broadcasting live for all North Texas. Fox 4 News at 6 starts now.
Losing weight is not easy, and many of us may be doing things that's not actually really helping us at all. We're actually adding weight, and we don't even know it. The herbal pharmacist, David Foreman, is here with some insight. A lot of us here on Good Day are addicted to our caffeine, and that could be a big problem, right?
Yeah, it's funny. When people are struggling with their weight, they always look at diet and exercise, but there are still people that are doing it right, and they can't figure out, why can't I lose the weight? And coffee could be, and we're not talking about those frilly foo-foo drinks that you can buy with extra sugar and whipped cream.
Right. Those obviously are not good, right?
I think most people get that. But coffee actually increases the production of a hormone called cortisol. Cortisol is called the stress hormone. Mm-hmm. And so instead of drinking coffee, I would recommend drinking green tea. You can still get that wake-up effect. Maybe you might have to consume a little bit more of it. But green tea also has a benefit of helping your body burn fat. So you kind of get a two-for-one special.
All right. I'm going to try to talk my co-anchor Tim into the green tea. I don't know if that's going to work.
If he gets grumpy, don't blame me.
Oh, he's already grumpy. Are you kidding? This isn't going to help. All right. Let's talk about date night. And, you know, it's so hard when you're going out and trying to find something to eat that's healthy.
Right. Well, it's funny because what happens when you sit down at a Italian restaurant, Mexican restaurant, is they throw a basket of chips in front of you or these breads that you just want to die for.
So good.
Well, those starchy foods are probably the biggest culprit in why you gain weight, especially, you know, people are eating out for lunch nowadays because who packs a lunch anymore for work?
Right.
So I'm telling people to avoid these foods, but they're addicting. They taste like sugar in your mouth.
Mm-hmm.
And so instead of, you know, being able to stop these cold turkey, I'm encouraging people to do that. But until you can, there's an ingredient called phase two. It comes from white kidney beans. So I brought an example. You can't possibly eat enough white kidney beans to get the effect of blocking the starch from breaking down.
Okay.
So there's an ingredient called phase two. This is just the capsule form of it. You take phase two before a meal with starches. It blocks your body's ability to break down the starches into sugar. And once you do that, you're less likely to gain the weight from it. It's kind of cool. So you can cheat. Actually, my little saying is, with phase two, you can enjoy a little bit more and absorb a lot less. It blocks up to 65% of the caloric effect from those starchy foods. But the best thing really is just to nibble and don't graze.
It's hard to have just one, though, isn't it? What about prescription drugs? A lot of people are on drugs, and it could be that could be, you know, adding to your weight gain.
Yeah, and this goes back to my pharmacy school days and me being a pharmacist. There are drug categories like antidepressants, blood pressure medications, anti-diabetic medications. These are all top of the list. They can be a contributing factor to why you're gaining weight. Don't stop your drugs, though, okay? Go back to your doctor or your pharmacist and see if they can change your medicine to something that's not causing that weight gain.
Mm-hmm. You have something called the superhero syndrome. What is that?
Exactly. That's me right here. Not because I'm ripped, but it's because we're doing too much.
Okay.
You know, we have an active lifestyle. We've got children. We're stressed out about finances. Those things just will increase that stress hormone we talked about earlier with cortisol.
Uh-huh.
So what I'm encouraging people to do, and cortisol actually in men will put belly fat on. Ladies will put it a little bit lower, and so a lot of people shake their head and they can go.
It's all in that same area,
right? Exactly. Get some more exercise. Get out.
Exercise.
Do some walking. Walk your dog. I have a dog. You know, we increased our length of walks. That helps decrease the stress. There are supplements that you can take. I went through a real stressful period in my life recently. I used two herbs. One called Relora. One called Holy Basil. Those are the names of them. So if you go to your local pharmacy, drug, you know, or health food store, you can find them by name.
And those seem to help out.
They work great for me.
All right, good to hear. And you can find a link to David Foreman, the herbal pharmacist, on our website, myfoxdfw.com. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.